Myself, Desi Pandey from Taipur Public School, Surajgarh. As I have delivered different lectures in the Animal Kingdom, Chapter 4 of Class 11 CBSE and RBSE. Today, the important topic is Phylum Platyhelminthes. What is the means of these Platyhelminthes? As Greek word, platys. Platys means flat. And helmin. Helmin means worm. It means the flat worms are placed in the phylum Platyhelminthes. Platyhelminthes term first of all reported by the one scientist Gegenbart in 1859. First of all reported the term Platyhelminthes term first of all given by Gegenbart in 1859. Platyhelminthes are generally present about the 13,000 species in the world. 13,000 species in the world. Platyhelminthes are called as flatworm, which generally has the dorsal ventral surface. Dorsal ventral surface. Platyhelminthes as important example is planaria. Planaria, which is free living Platyhelminthes member, and others are like the tapeworm, liver fluke. These are generally parasite Platyhelminthes. These are parasites in the human as primary host. Human as primary host. These are parasites, and you can say these are endoparasite form. These are endoparasite in the human as primary host. Because in case of tapeworm, two type of host is found. Generally, the tapeworm here, pig is considered as secondary host, and the primary host is considered as human. Human as primary host and pig is secondary host in case of tapeworm. Tapeworm, which is called as Tinea solium. Tapeworm as zoological name is Tinea solium, where Tinea is genus, solium is species. In the case of liver fluke, there are also human act as the primary host and the secondary host in case of liver fluke is sheep. Here secondary host is sheep. What is means of primary host and secondary host? This is the question. As primary host means where the sexual reproduction occur. Where the sexual reproduction occur, which is called as primary host. Platyhelminthes generally has the important characters which are given as like these are triploblastic animals. I have discussed
about the term trypanoblasty. Trypanoblasty means the animals as the ectoderm, endoderm and mesoderm, three general layers present. Such animal is called a trypanoblastic animal. Second character is body has dorsal or dorsoventral surface. Dorso means dorsal and ventral or ventral, two surface, hence it is flat. So flat worm are reported in the such characters of platyhelminthe. Characters of phylum platyhelminthe as reported here. The first one, trypanoblastic animals. Trypanoblastic means ectoderm, endoderm present. In between ectoderm and endoderm, mesoderm layer is present. Second one, body has dorsal and ventral surface, means flat worms are placed. Third condition is absence of the skeletal and respiratory system absent. Here presence of simple eyes in planaria. Simple eye present. And fifth important character is flame cell as excretory organ. Sixth one is dimorphism condition is not found. Seventh important character is bisexual animal means hermaphrodite. Bisexual animals means hermaphrodite. And next one, endoparasite mostly. So these are the important characteristic feature of phylum platyhelminthe. Now classification of phylum platyhelminthe. As classification, here phylum platyhelminthe as reported here, the phylum platyhelminthe is classified into three classes. Total of three classes found. These are named as Turbellaria, Trematoda and Cestoda. Turbellaria, Trematoda and Cestoda, these are total of three classes of phylum Platyhelminthe. In the Turbinaria genus, good example is Planaria. Planaria, which is called as the Deucia, as the Planaria is free living Platyhelminthe, has four important characters. This is the Planaria as dorsal body surface, which has one pair of simple eye. This is the simple eye, and this is the dorsal view of Planaria. In Planaria, in the dorsal view, presence of one pair simple eyes and presence of auricular process. This is auricular process. This is the dorsal surface of Planaria. Next one, if we see the Planaria ventral view, Planaria look like this. This is the ventral view, which contains auricular process and generally has the type of here in the Planaria presence of mouth at ventral surface, and below the mouth there is present of the excretory pore, means this is the as excretory pores. Here this is the considered as gonopore, not excretory pore, because the anus is absent in the phylum Platyhelminthe. In the ventral surface, mouth is present and gonopore is present. This is the posterior part. As auricular process present as the anterior part. This diagram for ventral view. So Planaria has the dorsal view, ventral view, two view shows different structure. As Turbinaria are mostly free living animal. These have mostly free living animals. Then Trematoda, which is generally endoparasite form. These are found as endoparasite. Trematoda important example is Fasciola. Fasciola hepatica is the zoological name of liver fluke. Fasciola is genus, hepatica is species, and it is the zoological name of liver fluke. As liver fluke has the such type of structure. Liver fluke is generally has the oval shaped structure, in which presence of the three types of pores are present. As anterior part, presence of the mouth, and posterior part, presence of the ear, the excretory pore, and at the middle here presence of the one small size structure as oral pore is present. just above the acetabulum. Here, this is acetabulum, and this part is called as oral sucker. Oral sucker, acetabulum, and this is called as gonopore. So, three types of pores are present. First pore is mouth, second is gonopore, third is excretory pore. Excretory pore present in the fasciola hepatica at the posterior end. Here, excretory pore present at the posterior end of fasciola hepatica. Although mouth present at the anterior end. So, fasciola hepatica, which is also as endoparasite, generally it is diagenic in nature. It is diagenic. Diagenic means it completes its life cycle in the two hosts. So it is diagenic endoparasite because it completes the life cycle into the two hosts, and one host is called a primary host. I have discussed already. Primary host is human and secondary host is sheep. In case of fasciola hepatica, it infects the liver. That is why the term has given for fasciola hepatica is, as common name is, liver flu. Because it infects the liver part, so name has given as liver flu. In the class cestoda, the good example is tapeworm. Tapeworm means worm is look like the tape structure. Tapeworm, which generally has the zoological name as Tinea solium, where Tinea is genus and solium is species. Tinea solium is called as tapeworm. Generally, this tapeworm has three parts of the body. This has three parts of the body. One is rounded part, and this contains the sucker. This is called as the scolex part. And this scolex part now has the very narrow neck part, and next part is called as strobila. Strobila as third part of the body of tapeworm. In the tapeworm, generally the scolex part has suckers. Here suckers are many, which generally attach with the host body. In the tapeworm, presence of the hooks in the two rows, total of 32 hooks, which is called a rostellum. Rostellum is present in the tapeworm, as the tapeworm zoological name is Tinea solium. As in case of Tinea segiata, which is larger size worms, which is also endoparasite, but the people who eat the beef meat, so it is called beef worm. As Tinea segiata, generally rostellum is absent, means hooks are absent in the scolex part. The sucker, which is present in the beef worm also. Body has neck part, which has a small size segment. After this, the strobila has three parts in the Tinea solium. Three type of segments, in which few segments are separated from the body. This type of segment is called as Gravid segment. Gravid segment separates from the body. This phenomena is called as a type of separation start the segment. This condition is generally occur in the Gravid segment, or you can say Gravid segment
Each semen has the developed testis, developed ovary. Ovary produces the ova and testis produces the sperm. So internal fertilization occurs in each semen. That is why Tinea solium consider as the animals of the animals, because the each semen is bisexual structure. As the gravid segment even part called as mature segment, which generally contain the testes and ovary in the developed part, but there is no formation of such type of eggs after fertilization take place. Before the such mature segment, this is the immature segment. So immature segment, mature segment and the gravid segment, three types of segments present in the case of Tinea solium. Gravid segment are separate from the body and comes out through the feces. This generally present in the feces, in the swine. When the any person generally takes the swine for washing the hands, this type of larva, in case of tapeworm, the larval forms are fine. As these larval forms are generally called as the one is spherical form, oncophore larva, then the hexacanth larva, then radia, then sarcaria and metasarcaria. Five larval stages are found in tapeworm. As five larval form stages is found in the case of Blastocystoda, in which the radia, sarcaria, metasarcaria are mostly found in the animal body. As hexacanth larva, which enters in the human body through the as infected soil by the small size soft structures below the nail part in the finger. Tinea solium, which causes a type of disease which is called as tineasis disease in the children. In case of tineasis disease, which is caused by the Tinea solium, generally the small child which is suffering by the tineasis has pale yellow color skin, weakness occurs, generally vomit occur. These are the symptoms for tineasis. As I have discussed three types of process in the phylum Platyhelminthes, once again repeats, these classes are, as first one is Turbilaria. First one is Turbilaria, in which free living cells are present. Good example is Planaria, which is generally free living, having the simple eyes at the anterior part in the Planaria body. One pair simple eyes present as starting, but presence of a ridge structure which is called an auricular process at the dorsal surface and ventral surface also. Presence of the mouth at the ventral surface posterior part in the Planaria. Here presence of the adhesive structure at the ventral part. This adhesive structure helpful in the adhesive part helpful in the attachment with the substratum. In case of as Trematoda, which is the second class of phylum Platyhelminthes, one member is Fasciola hepatica, common called as liver fluke, which is endoparasite in the body of the two host. As the Fasciola hepatica generally has the two host, one is called as pila, another is the sheath.
As I had discussed already, the primary host in case of liver fluke is human, that is not correct. It is bile and secondary host is seed. It has three types of hosts here discussed, as anterior part, mouth, then next one gonopore, which is present near the acetabulum, and at posterior part, a slippery pore is present. The two type of sucker present, one is called an oral sucker, and oral suckers is present around the mouth, another is called an acetabulum. This acetabulum is also called as ventral sucker. This is called as ventral sucker in case of Fasciola hepatica. It is diegetic endoparasite because it generally complete its life cycle in two animals. Next third class is Cestoda. Cestoda in which type 1 Milan, which geological name is Tinea solium. Tinea solium body has three parts. One is called as the scolex, next is neck, and third part is Stobila. So Stobila is third part, neck is second part, scolex is first part. Scolex contain the suckers as the dorsal suckers, lateral suckers, anterior suckers, four types of suckers present on different position. But in case of tape 1, prostatum is present, which contain hooks in two rows of 16 hooks, means 32 hooks present, which generally has the such type of structure. Each hook has the a small size blade. Blade now makes the last part, which is called as root, and the middle part, which generally called as the body of the such hooks. So this is the structure of one hook in the case of tapeworm. Tapeworm has three type of segment. One is immature segment, and next one mature segment, and last one gravid segment. Gravid segment, which detach the segments with the mature form testis and ovary, which produces the sperm and ovum after fertilization, eggs are produced. These segments reach outside through the feces and present in the soil. Then the oncophore develop the hexatent larva, which enters in the host. Then it has radia larva, circularia larva, and metacircularia larva. So it shows the indirect development by the larval stage, and mostly endoparasite except the class Turbinaria, means planaria, which is free living. So please like, share and subscribe my YouTube channel Super Classes.